Okay, here we are in part two of the series on the mindset of the super powerful. They're very rich, and they have a regressive alien extraterrestrial world domination and control mindset and nature about them. So in the first part, I talked about how they are and how they do things. Now let's take it into a present world situation. And you have to kind of watch the first one to get this one. And there should be a link down here to the first part of this if you haven't seen it. But the idea is that if you have a population of well-meaning beings, good-natured, they're loving, basically, I mean, we got a few kinks and rough edges and we get a little pissy sometimes as human beings. But in consciousness, we're generally caring. We care for others. We're empathetic. We're kind. We care about our loved ones and our family and our entire culture. And we would like to see a world of peace and love prosper and flourish. And so, of course, we want our own, but we want it for others too. We care. All right. So there's an entire population, millions or billions of people like this. And they're not into war, not even a little bit. Let's talk this out. Let's work out the differences. Let's be diplomatic. So, peace-loving, okay? Now, if you are part of a race of regressives that are into control and domination and being the powerful authority, the dictator, the ruler of the world, and it's a one-rule sort of world-governing thing you've got going, it's just you and your peeps, your family, literal family, your brothers and your sister, your mother, your father, your grandfather, your great-grandfather, great-great-great-grandmother, and on back through time, have all been of this ilk, have all been of this extraterrestrial nature. The consciousness is not human. The consciousness is born into a body and a bloodline that the bloodline and the family is already rich and powerful because of what I've laid out in the first section, first part of the video. And so now you're just born into the family. There's already riches and there's power and the command over money and life and banking and education and technology, because these families, especially when they work together, because this family, that family, there's more than 13 family bloodlines, but these family bloodlines, together, they work together because they are of the same ilk. They are of the same nature and kind in consciousness. They are regressive. Now, that's not good or bad. It's a definition or a label on a kind of consciousness that loves the control, domination, and power way of life, coming from another race, reptilians or all kinds of creepy ET races. We call them creepy. They call them normal. But that's how they live life. Military or through strategy, they go through and they control and they dominate world after world after world after world. It's like, it's not a lot different from the idea of Alexander the Great spreading across the planet, dominating this culture and this one and this one and this one, and putting it all under that rule. So it's just their nature. Like, why not? So with this going on, these non-human consciousnesses are born into various families, and the entire family has that powerful control and domination thing literally in their blood and in consciousness. And they have built the wealth up so much, this family and this family and this family, that they have trillions of dollars, billions and billions, hundreds and hundreds of billions and billions and trillions, and more than 1 trillion, 2 trillion, 5 trillion, 100, lots. They have so much power and control over finances that it's not a thing anymore. And these families, they are true to their roots. They worship their ancestors. They worship those above them in the hierarchy. And there are literally, this is reptilian consciousness in a human body, in a powerful position. I mean, super powerful position. And there's thousands and thousands of these kinds of beings in human bodies in positions of high level power. Okay? They're in government, and military, and finance, and banking, and in nobility bloodlines, and just everywhere. And in the news media. And so they have incredible influence all over the world. And these various families and groups, they organize themselves, and they're very organized and very structured. They've always worked in organized structures that are hierarchical. And you can get online and look. There's a deep state map. We'll give you a quick idea of all the incredible complexity of organization and how they work together and interact with each other. Sometimes they fight and bicker with each other, like family members will, or rival families, the Hatfields and the McCoys. They rivalry, but they're all in those powerful, rich, and controlling authoritarian positions, and they're organized, and they do things in an organized fashion, and they have their higher-ups. And these two families, or five or ten families, or these two or three business corporate groups, I mean, massive banking organization here that owns hundreds or thousands of banks. Be surprised how many banks that are owned by the Rothschilds, by the way. It's just like overwhelming. Just banks. Whoa. And then there's the Chase and the Morgans and the Rockefellers and the there's lots, okay? So with all this, they organize themselves in a hierarchical way. And they have to pay attention to what their higher-ups say. Because their higher-ups are in control. Each level is in control, I mean hard control, of the level below it. Boom, 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 boom. So you say, you do what you're told from your higher-ups. And so as you look at the levels of organization in the structure that is controlling a planet, you can see how this works. And it all trickles back up to the top. And at the top, the very top, you will find beings, non-human beings, that are incarnated into human bodies. They look human, they talk and sound human, but their actions are inhuman. They have a tendency to create wars. They have a tendency to deceive the population. It's how they do work to control an entire population of a planet. We don't have to talk about Earth. We can talk about any planet anywhere. Into the control and domination game. Now, they want the resources they can get from the local population. Now, they are very interested in, I won't go into the details too much, but they are interested in literally our brain power, our ability to create, and they will use that in various ways. Our bodies, literal bodies, they like to extract essence from the bodies. They body parts. You've heard of black marketing body parts. You know, hearts and livers. Well, there's more than hearts and livers being sold on the black market. But there's a lot of profit to be made off of a human body, off a human being, in many different ways. Enslavement and all this stuff. Many different ways. So each level of control is controlled by a higher level of control, up, up, up. And as you go higher up, at some point, you'll notice that this human being or this non-human consciousness is in a super powerful position, controlling an entire family line, an entire bloodline. Or you might have three or four of these non-human beings incarnated into these family lines, and they're controlling the non-human beings in their family lines. And yes, there can be some human consciousness that are a little quirky also in those family lines. Just because you're in one of these family lines I'm referring to doesn't mean you're of a reptilian consciousness. there's flexibility and there's variations in this stuff. But predominantly, you got that reptilian consciousness in these positions of power. But the bodies look human. But there's comes a point where this highest level of human bodies, their uppers, their bosses are not human, and they're not in human form. They're extraterrestrial, they're alien, their bodies are extraterrestrial, their bodies are alien, their bodies are reptilian, their bodies are non-human bodies. Okay? Now, these beings are so not human, it's ridiculous, and these beings are controlling things from up here. And one of those beings looks kind of like the devil. Looks like the classic idea of what the devil looks like. Kind of human, but kind of reptilian looking with the horns and the tail and the different features. So the humans are the reptilian consciousness in human form in these positions of superpower on the planet, doing all these things, manipulating wars, manipulating news, doing all this stuff because they are in control of those industries that will supply the war machinery. They are in control of the banking system that will give this warring nation and this warring nation enough money to buy the materials to build their war machines. And these same super rich, powerful beings in families and groups also are so powerful and rich that they've bought up the controlling interests in the media. Newspapers, magazines, radio, television, internet, social platforms. So they are in control of all of this, and they use all of this in very organized fashion to manipulate the belief systems of the population of the planet. Let's say planet Zerg. Because we're not talking about Earth here. No. We don't. The people of Earth have good, wholesome people in power. And our governments are working for us. And the news media is doing the best it can to report the news as it understands it. So we know this. So obviously I'm talking about, generally speaking, how a reptilian extraterrestrial race would control and dominate a planet. Not ours, though. We're fortunate in that way. Because we have highly intelligent, deprogrammed human beings everywhere, wide awake, knowing exactly what's going on. And we're telling everybody else. So everybody's waking up to how things really work. So we're good. But this other planet, Zerg, has having problems because of this control structure I'm talking about. And at the very top, the beings aren't even human. Now, are they the beings they will worship? I mean, devotion, worship, rituals, ritual magic, black magic, all this stuff. They will blood, ritual, magic, sacrifice, all kinds of wild and crazy stuff they will do. Because it helps them with the manifestation process of how realities are manifested. And all realities are manifested in consciousness using the imagination, and it has to do with what the population is thinking about, what they believe, what they focus on, and what they have strong feelings about. And this will, in mass, in group, it's called the unconscious mind of man, the mass unconsciousness, the consensus reality, is a manifestation of a reality that is experienced by the population of a planet by virtue of what the population is thinking, what they're focused on, and what they have feelings about, what they believe. This will begin to manifest that reality. Even if it's not true, it will gradually manifest into that truth and experience. So the super powerful and rich worship and do all these magic things because those are manifestation techniques, and also because they're honoring and worshiping their seniors, their next level up. Because if they don't, they're going to have serious repercussions. So it's a very tight, very harsh control mechanism throughout all these levels. And on the street level, they recruit on every level. They recruit regular human beings, and they seduce them with rewards and riches and great jobs and great careers and fame and fortune and success. And so great, talented beings that are normally wouldn't be bad in our eyes, they wouldn't be against humanity, have been seduced by what you would call the dark side. And they get their rewards in the profit. But they've also had to make oaths of allegiance to the highest level of control that is non-human on the planet. Not in a physical form, not human. And whether it is the actual individual or it's just a symbol and representation of one's oath of allegiance, it looks like the devil. So people worship the devil, they give their allegiance to the devil, and they make pacts and agreements with the devil. Satan, it's called Satanism. And so it all, the attention, the focus, and the attention goes up to one or a few. And even this one up here above has his other powerful beings of the same mindset, this reptilian, regressive, from our perspective, mindset. And that mindset is to be in control of the entire world. So it is. That's how it's done. And boom, 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 as it trickles down. And there, you can look, you can Google it and start researching this stuff. And you can see how what I'm saying makes sense and valid, and there's a lot of documentation on how this stuff works. And as much as I would love to talk about specifics, I'm keeping it generalized so you understand the bigger picture. And there's nothing I would like more than to zero in on specific targets and name names and name groups and stuff. But you get the picture. And I guess I'm telling you this for two reasons. One, I have a strong desire, urge, to share what I know about what's going on with others. It's to teach. It's to help enlighten, understand, awaken beings on this planet or any planet. That's kind of what I'm about. And I have to talk in this way because these platforms have been getting a little touchy about what you say about certain things. So I'm talking in this way. Normally, I wouldn't talk this way. I have some other platforms, and there's some other great video platforms. I have my stuff on one of the popular ones. All 1,000 videos I have uploaded here, they're uploaded over there. You can write to me and ask me about that. I'll be putting up stuff on other platforms. Some platforms will allow you to talk about certain things, but not about, you know, you can't talk about certain things. It's a violation of their guidelines. But you can talk about those things over on these other platforms. So I'm leaning toward these other platforms, but everyone that knows me and watches my stuff and that I can reach are here on this platform. So I'm doing the best to respect the guidelines and so that I can continue to reach you and talk to you. I'm looking for other strategies and ways to share my stories. I've got a lot of movie treatments, movie ideas I can share with you. But this is one of the most important ones. There's another part to this, but I just might make a fresh video about the subject. All right. I guess that's about it. Thanks for watching, and I will talk to you later, okay? Your comments are always welcome.